Hey everybody, it's Sly, and it is that time of year again. It's time to do the dare. That's right, I have to watch the movie Cats, one of the worst movies of all time, 10 times in a row. We've got big screen with cats on it, and we've got all sorts of snacks and provisions, but it's for a good cause. Last year we raised over $12,000 for local charities, and I just want to thank everybody for all of your support. And in return, this is what I'm going to do. Here we go. Oh God, this music is horrible. First beat. Oh my God. 10 times is gonna be so much. We watched Cats for the first time. The animation is horrible. I can see her human fingernails. Well, I will say there are no cat buttholes. A cat gets abandoned. Okay, we start off with a crime. What appears to be a well-to-do family has just abandoned an animal in the street. She's lucky though, because they are having a cat holiday and watch an old cat pick a slightly younger cat to basically be shot into the sky and be reincarnated. That's the gist.
All right, first screening done. You just watched it a second time.
It doesn't really get much better the second time.
Do you think there's any chance that you will like this movie after 10 viewings?
I think there is a higher probability this movie will make me crazy as opposed to me liking it. Hopefully this will help. I just want to point out once again that it says McCavity wanted for everything.
Is that what it said?
He stole a car. He's murdered a person. McCavity committed wire fraud. McCavity tried to kill the queens. Do you know that McCavity downloaded thousands of songs on Napster? Yes. Is it too much to ask for something special like using the topping to decorate the pizza like a cat's face?
Ooh, unfortunately we would not be able to do a cat.
Yeah, I think we're okay then. I appreciate it. I was looking for something okay. A little special. That was disappointing.
Oh! What was that?
That was a cat viewing thing.
Viewing number four. How are you feeling?
It's starting to feel it.
Got some pizza. It's time for our dinner break. John, there's a cat in the box.
What? Where? It's on the pizza.
It's on the box. You see it?
No. It's like, you see it on the...
You tell me you don't see that?
No, I don't see anything on there.
Okay, that's really weird.
You're right?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine.
All right, we are four screenings in. One more screening and we are halfway.
So is it about like as hard as you were thinking it was gonna be, kind of like some of the other dares?
It's less physically grueling as like a 5K with tacos and drinks or doing full day photo shoots for the calendar. This is more like mentally taxing. Mm-hmm. Like early on I was kind of bored and now I'm kind of like seeing things in the movie that I wasn't expecting. So it's like I'm trying to relax and trying to like chill and get through these, but my head's kind of like spinning a little bit.
It is 10:03 p.m. We've been at this for 11 hours.
Will you wear headphones?
Yes, I'll wear headphones. But that means I'm gonna have the movie piping into my ears with no escape for the next 8 hours, the equivalent of a full work day.
Are you looking forward to this experience?
No.
How's the headphone experience?
It's immersive, which sucks.
I think I'm hitting my second wind. I might grab an energy drink.
We'll go with lemon lime.
Nice.
I feel like there's probably a vitamin or two in here, right? No.
What do you think of the movie? What's your thoughts?
I think it's starting to chip away at me. Wasn't expecting it. Wasn't hoping for it, but you know, when you spend time with a lot of folks, you grow close to them, whether you expect to or not. And just these characters, they're becoming a part of me.
Is this for real?
I don't know. It's kind of like how I feel, like, you know, after spending time with good friends. You know, when this is over, am I going to miss them? It's hard to say. Over time, I think you can kind of see past the flaws and really just see what the artists were trying to do. For this next one, I'm going to watch the director's commentary, get a new appreciation for what it takes to make art.
Hello, I'm Tom Hooper, director of Cats. You sleepless? Mm-hmm. Characters can come from sleep.
Are you sleepless?
Wide awake.
You were sleeping a little bit.
How you feeling?
What? Check off viewing number 9.
You've done so great. Let's finish strong.
Let's finish strong.
Movie's still going. Well, that was interesting. Looks like I got 20 minutes left.
You did it, man.
I did it. It's done. Oh my God, please don't.
What is your final impression of the movie?
Honestly, not bad. I've seen every angle of this film, and I gotta give the artist some degree of credit for what they tried to do. But you know what? It was all about the journey.
So what journey did you think it took you on?
Wait, am I just back at home? Did nothing happen? Thought I was the Jellicle choice. That whole thing was bull. I don't feel so good. What's happening to me? I'm changing!
This dare, I've come to realize that you shouldn't judge a book of T.S. Eliot cat bones by its cover. Even though I wasn't excited to watch the movie Cats 10 straight times, and looked like something the cat dragged in when it was over, I wouldn't trade this experience for the world. It literally changed me. You would need 9 lives to do what I did to come out the other side as the Jellicle choice and get a new cat life. So I realized there's only one way to pay tribute to this year's dare. Thanks again, my feline friends. Garfield out.
After all of that, I just wanted to say thank you to everybody who contributed and supported us along the way. Donating dare is a lot of fun, but it also helps a lot of folks out in this community, around the state and around the country. So once again, when we pick it up again at the end of October, please donate and start thinking of your dares, and let's do it again.
Go get some sleep.